This is no ordinary cooking pot. This is бабушка's pot. This is бабушка's special кисель making pot. Бабушка poured it to me to explain to the world how to make the correct, the true Slav кисель. Don't worry, I will not break it. I've done this before. Some call it кисель, some call it кисель. I just call it strawberry motor oil. Do not talk to these people. You know what we call people who call кисель, кисель? We don't call them at all.
He is boring!
Five white tulips, бабушка's favorite, I know you're watching this video. Favorite grandson Boris here to educate the world. Кисель, made from dried fruit or fresh fruit, any fruit you find in the garden. But since it is winter, minus 20 degrees outside, all I could find in garden with this frozen fruit. It is no problem. As I said, you can even make from dried fruit. So go find those dried apple slices you forgot in the drawer 9 years ago. You also need sugar, some water, some potato starch. It has to be potato starch. We not squatting dogs here. And some top quality Latvian potato starch. Sent from the mastermind of Hard Buzz Yummy. Картофельня is what we need. Thank you. Ну, бабушка, лукуина, we need just a bit of salt. We hide this in the bag, just adding the secret. One potato mashing device, not to mash the fruit, but to keep away the кисель thieves. And next up, every and all glass containers you find in the house for pouring the ready stuff into. Let's make some chicken. Кисель, one of my favorite desserts of all time. And not just because it can be made at any time you want. It's so sweet, put sugar keeps the shame. Insert all the fruit you have selected. Scientific measurement if you can. Half a liter, there you go. And another half liter. It's about roughly 4 cups. I leave a match in description, no problem. Pick up the remaining ones, not what to anger the бабушка. Кисель is basically a compote. But for strong men. I have seen some people use blender on the berries. I say you'll throw the blender straight in the trash. You can mix paint with your blender, leave the berries alone. No, hey, twice the amount of water as we have berries. 1 liter of berries, 2 liters of water. Move the whole operation to the cooking area. Try not to burn the house down. If you have burned the house down, start again. Check out бельмининета, mix it around and wait for boil. If you're using fresh berries, you can dump the sugar inside right now. We do not. It's starting to smell like бабушка's house. As the heat is rising in the pot, remove some of this dust it has collected. This is кисель, not dust soup. Also watch out, metal handles on pot can be hot, but only if you do not drink a pot. Once the water starts boiling, just if the strawberries have completely melted. If yes, then add sugar inside. How much sugar we need? We need all the sugar. Now this part depends completely on how sweet your berries are. If you're using very sweet strawberries, you might not actually need any sugar at all. But at this crazy talk, you can always add more sugar. I put in a total of 16 spoons. Yes, tablespoons. Don't believe me, try it yourself, it's so good. How much in the description, go ahead. It is pretty much compote at this point. Now we just need to add the starch. We dissolve the starch in some water. Smell of potato. 6 tablespoons. Without a heap. For this amount, add a bit of water and mix it around. You see, кисель is not exactly liquid. But it's also not solid. Somewhere in between. It's like vodka. When you take it out of the minus 20 degree weather outside. Wait, it's not a bad idea. Vodka, кисель. Кисель shot! Давай! Pour the mixture into the soup. And you will instantly see you're turning into jam. Not worry, it is normal. Very carefully mix it around. If the fruit gets broken inside, this is not a bad thing, that is actually even better. Now some people use blender and boil this stuff until the strawberry seeds come to the top. Me, I have nothing to say about this. But бабушка, she said the same people who remove seeds from кисель are the same people who eat the compote with that fruit. Do not trust these people. Have small test, add more sugar if you like. Not me, it's already perfect. Stop boiling. Mission complete. Бабушка, look who она. Every good dessert has to have a bit of salt inside. Let's move over to topping station. Some use milk, some use ice cream, or whipped cream as topping under кисель, or just use mayonnaise. Sorry, бабушка, not when you have heart attack. Mayonnaise, we save for later. And make whipped cream. Components cream and whipped sugar, of course. We use whipped cream, like normal people. And you whip by hand. But this mixer use hand. Make you grow strong, like Boris. Or, okay, if you're in hurry. Only then you can use the... Sorry, бабушка, it's only business. What type of evil spirits? Бом, бом. Which you have angered your stomach for first just enough, it is time to sort it out. Now the whole thing should have at least cooled down a bit by now, so you don't completely shatter your glassware when you pour this stuff inside. Oh, it already looks delicious. Do not be afraid of the berries. Very good for you. Make you grow strong. Good. This one we save for later. For cool down, we put in the refrigerator. You see, just like compote, kisil can be eaten as cold or a hot soup? Is kisil actually berry soup? I do like soup. Slap a bit of mayo, oi, bleh. Put on a generous portion of whipped cream and let it dissolve. Or do not, just eat it. The mixture is perfect already, like eating cold sour cream with a hot borscht. Ideal for winter vacation after a long World War reenactment in the snow. And this is exactly the consistency you're looking for. This is the kisel that you probably know. Is your mama or babushka has made it with a nice topping. Sometimes whipped cream, maybe sour cream, maybe mayonnaise. But always with a glorious fruit inside. Thank you for watching, my friends. Now go make it yourself, because this one is mine. Stay cheeky breaky, my friends. I will see you next time.